how's everybody doing? I'm sorry I'm coming to you bald and, you know, unfresh, but a lot of people are always saying, what's your skincare? What's your skincare? What is your skincare? Disclaimer, I have good skin. I do next to nothing to maintain it, but I'm just going to show you guys the little stuff that I actually do to kind of keep the skin looking fresh and all of that. So I've had makeup on for roughly, since about 8 a.m. this morning. It's 8 p.m. right now, so it's about 12 hours. I have been in Lagos traffic. I have traveled from one state to the other. I have sweated. Yeah, I use sweated as a word. So this makeup definitely needs to go. My number one rule with makeup is do not sleep with makeup on your face. This little guy right here was because I actually fell asleep on Christmas Day. Yeah, after turning up with Chairman, I passed out with full-on makeup, lashes, everything on my face. So that's why I have this little bugger over here. So I'm going to show you guys what exactly it is I do to keep my skin looking fresh and clean. So first step, obviously, if you're not a glasses wearer, you skip the first step, is to take these bad boys off. Now I'm officially blind. Second thing I usually do is I have this. It looks dingy, but this is a secret to everything. My mom, being a pepekite that she is, actually made me fresh coconut oil. It's a bit coagulated because I traveled and it was on top of my dresser, so it's a bit coagulated, for lack of a smaller English word. But what I usually do is I take a little bit of the coconut oil, right? This I do about twice a week. If I wear makeup twice a week, then I do this. But on nights when I don't wear any makeup at all, I can't be bothered about it. So just take quite this little and do this. P.S. It smells like heaven. If you don't love the smell of coconut oil, something is genuinely, honestly wrong with you. So I just kind of rub it around my face. As you can see, it's thus. Because unfortunately or fortunately, I use Kajal. You guys, you see that mess. I use Kajal, and Kajal is one of the most difficult things to get off your face. So when I do this, I go in with my baby wipes. I have the one that's actually for babies. I went into the store and I tried to find the one that is for adults, but you know, they didn't have it. So I go in with my wipes, one full one first. I use about three, which is why I'm constantly always buying wipes. And then I just start from my nose. Look at the amount of product on there alone. The good thing with the coconut oil is it kind of, I don't want to say melts down. Keep in mind, I'm cleaning in one direction, you guys. I'm not cleaning all around and all around and all around. I'm just cleaning in one direction. So what the coconut oil does is it helps you kind of liquefy the makeup so it's not as baked. I mean, oil kind of removes stuff from the surface. I'm going to take another wipe and just kind of clean it all out. Go around my eye and just wipe because, yo, these products, I mean, this is on the second wipe, by the way. So now that my face has been wiped, it's a little damp. I go in with my Clarins. It is the exfoliating body scrub for smooth skin. It has bamboo powders. What else does it have? Bunch of other stuff. I didn't really read all these things, you know, to be honest. So just going with the little. Little goes a long way. And since my face is sort of already damp, just do this. Now, the key to this is actually rubbing it into your skin. For those who didn't see it before, this is what it is. I got it as a gift. Don't really know, you know, how much it is, but I'll figure it out when I need to buy it the next time, because to be honest, it actually works. It keeps my skin really hydrated because I have dry skin even though I sweat a lot. So this kind of keeps it kind of a bit less, you know, cracky since it's harmer time. So I'm gonna leave this on for about 5 to 10 minutes and then I'm gonna wash it off and I'll be right back. So guys, now that my face is a bit dry, I've washed off all of that. I stayed about 5 to 7 minutes. Washed off with warm water because I feel like warm water is the key to everything that is wrong with the world, okay? It's the key. So now I have some sort of black mask looking like Ojuju under my eye. So I'm going in with, I think, one of the oldest skincare remedies. This is the Boots skincare. It's basically glycerin and rose water. If you know what rose water is, It is amazing, amazing for your skin. Keep in mind, guys, I don't use rose water every day. I only do this mostly on the weekends when I know I've had a face full of makeup. So I soak my cotton wool in that, and then I literally just take it. Do you guys see? And then after that, I'm just gonna do my whole face, just kind of to mop up whatever might have been left from the makeup. What rose water also does is it helps sort of even out your skin tone. If you have like patches on your face of uneven skin, rose water and glycerin is definitely your friend. Gives you a more even fresher tone. Your skin, if you're having discoloration issues, this bad boy here is your best friend. Now guys, the very last thing I do, I don't even know why you guys want this video, because to be honest, if not me, I don't go watch them, but you guys better watch it. The last thing I'm going in with is my night repair serum. I think you can get this either at Adiba or basically in any market. I'm going to show you guys what it looks like and then show you how I apply it. So the thing with this is it is the Argan Oil Night Repair Serum. If you want to know the original, it usually has this cap thing around the side, because obviously we're Nigerians, they must do fake of everything. So this is basically like a night repair serum. It has Moroccan argan oil extract. It's pretty intense, so don't use this a lot if you get it. It's less than 3k for the bottle, and I like how it comes. It's literally like, you know how when you were a kid and they used to put vitamin C in your mouth? That's how it is. So you just drop one or two or three drops all around your face, and then you just rub it in. Skincare isn't easy, but my skincare tips are pretty cheap. And then when it dries off, you just go to bed. I mean, like guys, I have pretty good skin. My mama, shout out to you, shout out to Pops for the good skin. So I don't really do a lot to maintain it, but the good thing about all these products is anybody with any kind of skin tone or skin sensitivity can use them, because they're basic all-around good products. You don't need to do too much. Also, like I said at the beginning of the video, don't sleep with your makeup. Drink as much water as you can, and please find makeup products that your skin doesn't react to. If you have oily skin, get what's good for oily skin. Don't get something that's gonna make oily skin oilier. But guys, here is to a 2020 of popping skin, glowing bank account, and all round bouginess. Anyway, I'm off to bed. I'm done. I'm off to bed. Good night, guys.